The following program is brought to you by Gizan Productions.
The podcast no one listens to, with Kevin Porter.
Nice. Fourth, fifth time, whatever, dude. The sixth time's the motherfucking charm. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Kevin Porter. What's up? Welcome to the podcast that everybody's listening to right here on... I'm not on a network, dude. We're too cool for school, dude. That's what we are, man. No one's offered me any money for this shit yet, dude. I'm fucking slacking, dude. I need to get a producer in here. It's just like, well, how many people are working on this podcast? Like, it's a one-man show, bro. How you promoting this shit? It's like, I don't know, dude. I'm off social media officially, dude. Officially dropped my Instagram. Boom, deleted, gone, dude. It's over with. Twitter, gone, fucking boom, over with. Facebook deactivated, but I am still using Messenger, so you can still hit me up on Messenger because I have to use that for the fucking podcast, dude. So fuck me in the ass, dude. Seriously, it's just like all I gotta do is like literally anybody that I have normally on the podcast, I just gotta send a text, be like, hey, dude, I'm deleting Messenger. You wanna be back on the podcast? Give me your phone number. Give me them digits, motherfucker. But I'm too lazy to do that. So here we are, dude, with an all-new episode of the podcast no one listens to. And it feels fucking great, dude. Fuck social media, dude. I hate it. It's a piece of shit, dude. All it is just people fucking getting on there and like, oh, look what I did. Oh, virtue signaling, all their fucking shit, dude. It's like, I don't fucking care, man. And I know I did the same thing, dude, but I was ashamed of myself, too. I was going on there. I was like, fucking Kevin Porter, what are we doing here, you piece of shit? Get off this motherfucking garbage. It's like, all right, man, I listen to my mind, dude. I listen to my conscience, dude. That's what I do here. So if you're watching the video portion here exclusively on YouTube.com, the podcast no one listens to, search us out. Subscribe, rate, give us a review, man. So as you can see, there's something different about me. It's like there's a glow about you, Kevin. What is up? Operation Ivy hoodie right there, bro. Oh, yeah, dude. I had to wait like a whole... like, dude, 2 fucking months for this shit to show up, dude. For one, I ordered off my fucking Amazon account, which is not Prime, so it fucking ships, you know, like, it's supposed to be 7 to 10 days, but I ordered this, like, a month ago, and, like, apparently the day it was supposed to be delivered, I get a notification saying, like, hey, guess what? You know that Operation Ivy, that sweet hoodie that you fucking ordered? Well, guess what? It's not gonna be delivered, and you're getting a refund in 3 to 5 days! What the fuck is up with that, dude? So I assume the freight truck that had the original order on it crashed into a fiery inferno and that hoodie got burned up, dude. But guess what? I got another one. So, hey, you know, the person I bought it from, they're like, damn, dude, such a nice hoodie sweater. Well, I guess they had to refund me, so they probably knew. Whatever, dude. Whatever. Something a little bit different about me as well. Cut my fucking long hair off, dude. As you can see on the video portion, dude, I finally cut it off, dude. I went in there and I told the lady, I was like, give me the most populist haircut, popular and it's haircut give me the haircut the kids are craving these days, man. So I don't know, it kind of looks, I don't know, I think it looks pretty cool on me. I don't think it looks that stupid. I wasn't even wearing a hat today, dude, but my fucking, the product, they call it product. Oh no. The product, just did not hold up as well as what the lady had used on my hair when I left the stylist shop yesterday. So, shout out to that lady that cut my hair. So she was a nice lady. But 2 years of growing my fucking hair out. You know, I've done this multiple fucking times over my life where I grow my hair out and then I just get a fucking hair up my ass and I just cut it, dude. And again, this one was like, it kind of was yesterday. It was one of those things where it was like, you know, I'd scheduled to cut it a couple weeks ago, but I was actually just going to trim it up to my shoulders. But I don't know, man, I just got sick and tired of it. And I decided to put it off here a couple weeks ago. And then I was like, I normally would make a scheduled appointment to get my hair done or get my beard done or whatever, but it was just like yesterday. It was just one of those things where it was just like, you know what? Fuck it. I need a change, dude. I need a fresh fucking start. Let's go cut the hair today. So went in yesterday and was able to get that done. So I don't know, ladies and gentlemen, it feels good. I feel 10 pounds lighter. And yeah, so I don't know, man, that's kind of where we stand at this point. feeling pretty good, man. You know, again, bringing in those positive vibes, you know, trying to make it through the week, dude. Been a single dad all fucking week, dude. That's right. Divorce. No, just joking. I'm just fucking joking with you, dude. Don't take me seriously. It's a podcast. It's a fucking podcast. No, dude, Jessica's with her family down in Arizona on some personal business. So I got the fucking kids for the week. So that means I'm getting them up in the morning. I'm fucking taking them to school. I'm picking them up. I'm fucking getting them home. I'm making them dinner. And then you know what I'm doing? I'm making them do the dishes because you know what? Alpha. Ah, dude, fucking, let's not lie. Let's not lie. Fucking Jessica's alpha. But I'm alpha when she's not there. So it's like, no, you're not. Shut the fuck up. The dog rules the house. He's like, the dog's like, feed me now. I'm like, oh, yes, master. Yes, master. I don't know, man. Been chilling, dude. Got a new kitty cat. I don't even know if we talked about him, dude. Max, dude, he's been in our house now for about 3 weeks. Fucking cool as shit, dude. Still miss Stanley. We'll always miss Stanley. But damn, dude, Max is a cool fucking cat. I don't know if talked about him on here before. Probably have, probably not. I don't know, dude. I don't listen to these things after these things get recorded. For the most part, I don't ever listen to this shit again, you know. So it is what it is, man. It's fucking the day before Halloween, October the 30th. Woo-woo-woo-woo. I hope you guys have been enjoying our little not necessarily reviews, but just like sharing, you know, what we've been watching, you know, the last couple weeks, dude. Again, watch the Nightmare on Elm Street, the original. Always a classic. I watched Friday the 13th, the original. Another motherfucking classic. Don't tell Jessica, but I'll let Jory watch the first It and the second It this week. Hasn't technically happened yet as I record this, but we plan on watching those. He's seen the first one, and, you know, Jessica's just so she very sheltering of these kids when it comes to the entertainment that they consume, which is, you know, understandable, dude. I get it. You know, I'm not necessarily out there. I'm like, yeah, let's watch a, you know, whatever, dude. I don't just let my kids watch random rated R movies. Depends on what it is. It really does depend. But I don't know, dude. Jory's fucking, dude, he's turning 15 in 2 months, dude. It's like, if you want to watch a scary movie, dude, it's like, we can watch a fucking scary movie. I think, I don't know, I didn't do what my dad did to me at like 5 years, you know, not even fucking before five, dude. I watched Nightmare on Elm Street when I was like 3 or 4, dude. The fifth one, you fucking pussy, dad. Like, what the fuck? I guess it was brand new on video, dude. You had to check it out. You had to find out how bad it was for yourself, you know, just like, dad's probably just like, oh, what the fuck? You're going to shit your fucking pants, you little asshole? You fucking pussy. This ain't fucking real shit. Go watch Nightmare on Elm Street Part 3, bitch. Part 1, motherfucker. Oh, so I don't know, dude, but we're going to watch those. I watched Creepshow, dude, the TV show that's exclusively streams on Shudder. I think it's on AMC as well. But I picked up the first season here not too long ago, and last night was, like, the first time I had the chance to, like, sit down and actually watch. I watched 2 episodes, so I watched, like, The Grey Matter. There's an episode about some dollhouse where these figurines were, like, haunted and shit, and, like, people were getting their heads chopped off. It was pretty crazy. I watched that, and there was, like, 2 other ones. There was one with DJ Qual with, like, this, like, character that looked, like, straight out of fucking Aliens, dude. Is it Qual, the guy from like Road Trip or whatever? It's like, whoa, 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 whoa. Where's that guy's name been, huh? It's like in the gutter. That's fucking where. But watch, and that was all right. I don't know. I don't think the thing actually existed. I think it was just like crazy in his head or something. I don't fucking know, dude. You're going to have to go watch it. But I definitely want to make my way through all the season, the full season, I should say, for Creepshow. Because it is definitely, it feels like it is a really good throwback to the original Creepshow. It's really an ode to, really, to the original one. I mean, anybody that's like, I don't know, dude, I was on like Facebook here a couple weeks ago, and some bitch was all like, oh, Creepshow 3 is the best. Like, you gotta check it out. And then, like, I just, like, was just kind of being nice instead of, like, trashing her and just be like, hey, you know what? Fuck twad. You know, you're a fucking retard. Like, you just go fuck yourself. Like, you don't know what you're talking about. Creepshow 3, what? Nah, dude. Nah. It's a fucking, I've never seen it, dude. But Brandon Allen has fucking told me that is a piece of fucking shit. I will never fucking spend time on that. But Creepshow 2 is one of those ones that, you know, it kind of grows on you. The first time you watch it, you're like, wow, this is not like the original, dude. Where's Adrian Barbeau? Where's Tom Atkins? Like, no, we get the guy that's a fake Indian. We get some guy that's all some creepy fucking rapist that ends up getting killed by the fucking blob. It's like, ah, he deserved it. He fucking deserved it. So, yeah, Creepshow 1 really is the best. And the TV show is definitely a good, you know, ode to the past there. So, definitely gonna keep watching it, dude. Shout out Shudder. What? I guess Shudder is supposed to be a pretty cool, like, streaming site, which I've never really gotten onto it because, like, I don't know. Dude, I have such an extensive like collection of horror films at this point. So it's like, I don't need to see crappy B ones. I barely can watch the ones that I already own. So on top, I know, dude, it's like, I don't really have, outside of just, we have the Prime streaming just for the fact that comes with your Prime account. And I have Hulu only because that comes through my fucking cell phone bill, which I'm dropping that motherfucking fuck you Sprint T-Mobile piece of shit. Fuck, it doesn't work anywhere here in this fucking town, dude. It's like, unless I'm like fucking on like central, like in the middle of the city, dude. That's the only place it works. But on the outskirts, dude, I get like 1-2 bars at best, dude. I'm rocking 2 bars right now, dude. And I'm on a fucking hotspot, so whatever, dude. I don't even know what the fuck to talk about, dude. Like I said, man, I've been trying to be positive as fuck, dude. Smoking, still in that Columbia River Reserve, dude. Really fine sativa. Picked up a pretty decent indica this week. I can't remember the fucking name. It's got like a fish. It was some brand I've never even tried before, which I found out, like anybody here in Washington State, there's a brand called Flav for like these edibles, dude. Like that you get the leather, but you can get leather belts, which aren't technically leather. They're really sour candy. Just a little bit. Let you guys know, I'm not eating real fucking leather, but like, you know, it was like old things that you used to get like in elementary school. They're like leather strips or whatever, dude. Like you can buy them at the Fred, you know, at the Fred Meyers and Safeway or whatever. And it's, you only got that because your mom didn't want to buy you a fucking candy bar. And you're like, you cheap fucking bitch. So, but dude, yeah. And I don't know. The fruit leathers I don't like because I don't really like sour candy. But like I always get gummies, dude. I always get edible gummies. And the guy fucking told me last time I went in there that they were going to stop fucking selling, or that brand's like sold out to another larger brand or whatever in there. Weren't going to make it anymore, which I was just like, whatever, dude, whatever. I was like, they'll make another one. So I was a little worried about it, but you know, it's, again, dude, like it's not like they're going to stop selling edibles anytime soon here, but it is what it is, man. So shit, dude, before we get into the main portion of this, I only have one thing to share with you guys this week. So this is one thing I've started my way getting through season one, and then there's 7 seasons of this fucking box set, dude. And like, again, like, I'm going to find the time over the fucking years, dude. If it takes me 15 fucking years, I will make my way through this series. But we got, just time for Halloween, Tales from the Crypt, dude. Seasons 1-7, dude. Again, talking about Creepshow, the original, you know, dude. I mean, Tales from the Crypt, dude. What else can you say, dude? I didn't realize as a kid, man, because I didn't get to see anything on HBO. Because my parents were fucking poor, dude. HBO was the thing that you got when you were on a road trip. In a hotel, which, dude, never happened with my mom. My mom never took us on a fucking road trip. The only time I ever remember staying in a hotel was when my mom's boyfriend got arrested because we got pulled over in Portland, and he had to go to fucking jail. So we had to end up in a fucking shitty-ass, flea-ridden fucking motel or some shit, dude. I don't know. I remember coming home, and we stayed at somebody's house that weekend. I remember getting fucking bug bites everywhere, and I was like, Mom, you bitch, you ever fucking take me to so-and-so's fucking house again, I'll fucking kite you. Fight you, whatever, dude. Kite you. I don't know, dude. We're getting to, again, you know, calm it down. I don't know. So I'm gonna try to watch that, some of that this week here, along with the, you know, the Creepshow season one. So I don't know, dude. There's some other movies I wanna definitely check out, dude. I downloaded the House of 1,000 Corpses trilogy, that Rob Zombie trilogy. So I think that should be fun to watch. I haven't seen those movies. I've never even seen the third one, so definitely the first 2, though, I've not seen in a very long time. All right, ladies and gentlemen, well, that's going to do it here for us for the opening, you know. So I think we're just going to jump right in without further ado. Before that, we got plugs. Oh, shit, dude, we always got fucking plugs. Speaking of, you know, Jay Mcnay, dude, check us out on Are You Ready, a professional wrestling podcast. I see the numbers, dude. You guys out there, you're enjoying it, dude. I'm getting the emails. I'm getting the feedback, dude. I'm tickled fucking pink on the inside about how you guys are reacting to this podcast, dude. And it's been so much fun, dude, doing this week in, week out with Jay Mcnay. Fuck, dude, for the past, like, this year, dude, basically has been the formation of this podcast. That's the one positive thing to come out of this fucking year is this Are You Ready, a professional wrestling podcast. But you can check that out every single Monday, dude. We've done some really cool episodes, dude. This week we did Halloween Havoc 1996, which we're trying to figure out a way to, like, watch these 3-hour pay-per-views without getting burned out, dude. So we may have to take them in 2 sessions, because by the time you get to like that main event, we're just like, come on, dude. This, like, these WCW shows are so fucking boring in the mid-90s, dude. So it's like, you know, by the end, you were just like, I think we picked it up pretty well, dude. I think for every episode that's over 2 hours, I really think me and Jay bring it every single fucking week. But yeah, we got to figure something out, and we're gonna figure it out, dude. Because we're that's what you do in America, man. That's what you do. You figure problems out and you fix it. So, all right, ladies and gentlemen. So go ahead, subscribe to that. Find us on YouTube. Again, we're not on fucking Facebook anymore, dude. So can't go like us on there because you know what? Fuck you, Facebook. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Without further ado, I give you Jay Mcnay.
All aboard.
But yeah, that's one of those games that there's like 10 or 11 or like 20 dudes around you, and you got to hit all the right combinations and all the right places. And if you do, you're rewarded with like all sorts of cool sequences and stuff. But if you don't, and if you lose like the flow of it, you just end up getting your ass kicked over and over again. And that's when I just, yeah, I just, fuck this. I'm just playing Madden again, where I know I could actually just cheat and win and feel good about myself for once.
Put that shit on rookie, dude. You know, it's like, dude, fucking 85 to 10. He was like, they're lucky they got those 10 points. It should have been a complete shutout.
Yeah, almost restarting. Yeah. It's like, ah, I wanted that shutout. I wanted to throw that shutout.
Yeah, dude. I was playing it was a PlayStation 2 game, The Warriors. You remember that? You remember the movie?
Oh, fuck yeah, dude. That's a good one.
Yeah, man. Like, I got pretty decently far in that game. And I say decent, like, for me, dude, like, you know, saying off mic, like fucking for me, dude, like whenever I get frustrated with the game within just like minutes, dude, I give up like instantly. Mm-hmm. Dude. I don't even have a problem. It's like, oh yeah, you know, I may have, you know, paid the $5 to rent this game tonight, but you know what? Fuck it. I'm playing. Like you said, dude, just go back to the games that you're good at. Yep.
And, I'll show you PlayStation.
Yeah, yeah, dude. And then there's this really hard part though in that Warriors game where you had to like go around, tag a bunch of shit, dude. You gotta be so like precise, but you gotta move quick enough because you run out of spray paint. And it's just like, dude, mm-hmm. fuck this. Like, I got stuck on it, dude. And my youngest dude, he has like the patience of a saint when it comes to me. He's just like, you know, he just sits in, he gets in the pocket, dude, and just he barrels through. I'm like, did you beat that part? He's like, oh yeah, dude, I beat that game already. Like, instead of a bitch.
Dead, like, you fucking fool. Yeah, well, I get frustrated.
You get frustrated.
Yeah, dude, I could never do, like, the Mega Mans and stuff like that. Even, like, what's that?
I love Mega Man.
What's the Hedgehog? Sonic. They're hard. Those games are too hard.
I got hard on Sonic. Sonic was my jam.
Too hard for me. I couldn't do this. I couldn't do the thing where you play, like, the same level over and over and over because there's one, like, triple jump that you have to hit perfect. I would just like, I would lose it. I wouldn't get any better. I'd just slowly get worse and I'd slowly just fucking derail and just not be able to play it ever again.
Jeez, that's like Super Mario World, dude. Like I've gotten so far and that I committed, dude, when I first got like that modded Xbox, I played the out of Super Mario World, dude. And I got, you know, the cool shit about that is because, like, you got save points, dude. So it's like all like the minis and all this shit, dude, you just fucking save it and you don't even got to worry about it. It's like back in the day, when we were playing Sega, it's like my mom would be like, oh, we got to go to the fucking store. And I'm like, what the fuck? Really? I'm on level 8 right now. I'm about ready to fucking beat this game, bitch. And you got to press start and hope your shit doesn't fucking fail.
Yeah, I hope it doesn't overheat while you're at the store. It's just the fans just kicking into double time. That's so weird. That was so deranged of the game developers back then to not, they put a checkpoint in every like 2 hours or something. Just, oh, that would be the worst ever.
I know, dude. You just have to barrel on and just like hope you get to that point to where you can like possibly save it. Which not all games like didn't have save points. I mean, like Donkey Kong, you had a save point. Mario, you had a save point. But Sonic, man, that's what I'm referencing, bro. Like I would fucking that thing did not save at all. Like
no time to save.
Go, no time. Go. Moving so quick. I don't remember the Sega games really having a lot of save points, honestly.
I wonder if it had something to do with like the requirements, you know, the system memory or some shit like that. Yeah,
that actually makes
sense.
I'd have
so many games where like I'll be like, oh, I haven't played this game in a while. It's pretty good. I don't remember why. And then I put it in and be like, oh yeah, I've been stuck on this level for 5 years. There's one little part in this level that I play 3 times, get frustrated, and then just never get past.
Which just sucks, dude. Like I even find that now. Like I've been playing, like I'll play on my Switch, dude, like my Nintendo Switch, like I feel like that's like my main console that I use because my kids are always on the PS4 and shit. And dude, I really should like assert my authority and be like, it's my TV. It's my PlayStation. Get the fuck out of here. Go to your room, bitch. And be like, ah, don't call the bitch. And I was like, calm down. But no, dude, I'll sit on that, dude. And like, I've been playing this one game, The Messenger, dude. I've had it for like a year and a half at this point. And there's this one part, dude, like I got stuck on it, right? And then like I go to play it, and it's like kind of the complete opposite. You'd think like my kid ended up like beating the level that I got stuck on.
Nice.
And so I was at some point of the game, like where they got to, and like I was just like, I had no idea what was going on, and I was like, you know what, fuck it, I don't even want to play it anymore. Because yeah, I wanted to beat the challenge, you know. I didn't like want to be a bitch ass, you know, pussy and not be able to beat that, you know.
Yeah,
that's where my kids come in, dude. That's a father in 2020, man.
Yep, that's what having kids used to be, to run the farm, and now it's to beat the video game levels that you can't beat.
It's true, you know, dude. It's
a little more fast twitch muscle or whatever it is, a little more cognitive ability. And I have a problem with like the gamey games, though. That's kind of like why Mega Man's cool, but it's not like you're never like emotionally involved in Mega Man's journey, especially when you die 100 times trying to do like the triple jump thing. Cause that to me is just like a whole different mindset. That's more like you said, you get the accomplishment from doing the thing in the game, but it, you know, I'm more, I guess you'd call like a casual, or I'm sure real gamers would deride me or whatever the word is, but like, I just want to like feel something. That's why I like Fallout's pretty good at that. I like those like Mass Effect games and shit that like you actually like, I mean, I guess you're kind of almost just playing like a movie, but that's another, because you hardly ever lose, because you're just like, basically they have it laid out for you and you're just like experiencing it, you know.
Like, you don't even have to take into account the amount of lives that you have. You're just like, it's unlimited, bro. They're just gonna let you start over whatever point you failed at.
And really, there's like, it's very easy to, I mean, maybe not like with Fallout, but with a lot of those like more movie type games, you can play through the whole game and not even die, because it's not even about like that. It's not about like the hardness of being able to beat it. It's more about like, I mean, it sounds so stupid, obviously, but it's more about like the choices you make and all that stupid shit, you know?
Right.
I need them to make me feel something.
Ooh,
the only thing I can feel is through video games, though.
Yeah, dude. And all the kids now, they're playing like fucking Fortnite and shit, dude. Like, my kids are like, oh, let's get Fortnite. I'm like, nope. Like, yeah, even when we have the internet, dude, I'm not even going to let them get it.
It's just like,
this game is stupid as shit.
And I'm sure I would get addicted to it if I played it enough, because there's something addicting about it. There's something fun about it. There must be, for all those people playing it. But even that, like, I don't know. It's such a weird, such a fine line to walk of like, when is it just a fun kind of thing for relaxing, and when are you really actually wasting your day and ultimate life playing Fortnite 10 hours a day or whatever, you know?
Yeah, I would argue, 10 hours a day probably is a little too much, dude. You know,
well, certainly that, yeah.
But I don't know how much,
you could make the argument that an hour a day is too much, unless you, I guess, try.
I don't think so, man. I think that all depends. Yeah, I think that all depends on like what you do in your day, you know? Because I was just thinking that shit today, dude. I was like driving into work, and like I was thinking, like, I was like, you know, where I'm in life right now, it's like, do I really deserve any of the stuff that I've got, you know, blah, 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 all that stupid
shit. I don't deserve
anything. I'm a piece of shit, Jay. I'm a fucking piece of shit. And
the
so, like,
cat nine tails out, whipping yourself. I understand.
I'm just thinking in my head, dude. I'm like, you know, what have I really done? Like, it's not like I'm just like, I've gone above and beyond and shit. It's just like, I get up every day, I go to fucking work. And I thought about that, like, thought really stuck with me. It's like, you know, even though that seems like such a simple fucking thing, like, there's so many people out there that just give up, and they like, I was just reflecting on people I know, you know. It's just like, those people just give up, and they just stay home all day. They don't even try. And it's just like, well, I guess on that level, okay, I guess, you know, I have earned it. But, you know, it's just still, dude, it's like, some people just stay home all day and play video games. Like, we had this buddy back in high school, dude. And I remember in high school just being so jealous of him, dude. I'm just like, oh, man, your mom lets you stay home. She buys you weed, man. You just hang out, play PlayStation 2. And, like, you know, it's just – but you look back 15 years later now, it's like that guy's still doing the same fucking thing, dude.
Yeah.
You know, he's never going to be able to afford a mortgage or anything like that, or just, like, take care of a family, because he just fucking stays home and just fucking plays video games and, you know, watches TV. You know?
It's a fine line to walk. You got to – and that's, like you said, I mean, it's not even about like becoming the next fucking Bill Gates or something. Mm. It's just like, just wherever you start, you know, trying to, wherever anyone starts, trying to just, maybe take one or two little steps up in your own, for your own benefit, you know?
Yeah, man, it's good to have goals in life, dude. Like, you can't just like walk through life and just be like, gonna be like, man, I want to better myself, dude. Like, if you don't think that way, dude, I really do feel like that's where a lot of depression comes from. It's just,
Oh, yeah.
You don't have something to look forward to, man. I mean, fuck, if COVID's taught me anything, it's, dude, like, set goals in life even more now. It's like, we're going to do this, 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 and then we're going to fucking concentrate on it. We're going to make it happen.
And it doesn't even matter what the goals are. That's exactly the hurdle that I think a lot of people have a hard time mentally getting over, where it's like, nothing matters. What's the point? And we've all, like, kind of been there to a certain point. And it's like, yeah, if you look into any one thing hard enough, you could make a good argument that none of it fucking matters. But exactly, at the same time, that's why you got to give meaning to things, right? Like, you got to, like, okay, I like to cook. So to me, it matters to make a nice dinner tonight and then, like, enjoy that, you know?
Yeah, dude. I mean, it's dude. And plus, cooking's so much fun. Like,
everything. If you just, like, well, and that's, you know, I mean, not to be like an old man about it, but I really think,
oh, also, let's go old man, dude. We're going
full
old man,
full 30-year-old old man. I really do think, and I haven't watched it yet, but I've heard a lot of people talk about the Social Dilemma on Netflix. I guess it's a documentary about.
Oh, I've seen that. Did you watch it? My wife, like, forced me to watch it.
Yeah, and I think we've talked about, I remember, like, last time we were talking, or one of these times, we were talking about how, like, from what I can tell, they basically just explain how the social media is engineered to give you stuff that you hate and makes you mad because it keeps you engaged for longer and more often and shit like that, right?
Yeah, dude. I mean, it totally, you know, manipulates your fucking brainwave patterns and shit. Right. Dude, like, it's like, ah, yeah, get mad at Antifa, get mad at the Proud Boys,
And then also, like, to go back to what we're talking about, it seems like social media is a big part of never having your own life be enough. You're always looking at, like, what someone else is cooking, or where someone else is eating, or they're on vacation somewhere, instead of just enjoying making a nice little meal for yourself or your family. Like, you're always worried about what the other person's doing and how much better their shit is, you know?
Yeah, I think, and you know, it's weird, dude, because, like, I don't necessarily let myself, I don't know about you, man, but, like, I don't necessarily let myself fall into that factor, dude. Like, I really don't try to, like, get jealous of people, you know, when I see other people, like, you know, doing nice things, I'm like, oh, dude, good for them. It's taken a long time, dude, but, like, especially over the last, like, you know, 5 to 10 years, man, it's, like, really trying to, like, you know, just force out the positivity in life and just be like, you know, like, good for them. They fucking earned it, dude. They deserve that. And not holding that jealousy. But, like, when you really do think of, like, society, though, I mean, because, like, you know, we're all engraved in our own little fucking bubble. So, you know, like, I don't know. I'm very, like, I don't know. I'm not, I don't know. Maybe naive's, like, the best way to put it, dude. I'm pretty fucking naive when it comes to, like, just how the world works sometimes, and, like, how other people are fucking living life and shit. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. I find it, like, surprising to hear that, like, you know, people just, like, really do dwell into that social media lifestyle. You're just like, you know, it's just constant negativity and shit. And then when you see it, you're just like, fuck, man. Like, you know, it just makes you want to fucking be that much more positive and just like, I don't want to fucking, like, be around any of that negativity right there. So, again, like, crazy. I've been very, like, conscious about how social media is for years at this point, dude. And, like, even though I'm still on it, and I know it still probably affects me to a point, but, like, I really try not to, like, I don't know. I'm always, like, trying to be like, okay, this is the last time, dude. We're downloading Instagram. And then, you know, 2 days later and you're like, fuck that piece of shit. Or you redownload after that. Yeah.
Seems like it's important just to be, at the very least, just being aware of it would be the first step, right? Like you're saying, like, just understand what it is and what it isn't. Right. And, you know, if you feel you can kind of almost feel yourself slipping into it too much. And that's where you just got to kind of pull yourself back, you know, like that river of ooze underneath New York City in Ghostbusters 2, where it's like, oh, that's a pretty dude, color. I'm just serious. You hear all those voices, they're all arguing. That sounds like fun. And then no, not for me. He's got to pull back and look at some cat videos.
Yeah. That's a crazy thing. It's a really good comparison, dude. That really
that's
is.
Like
comparing social media to Ghostbusters 2. Like,
I need to watch that again. Remember where they put all that shit? That's like they slop a bunch of Twitter on a toaster and then it just becomes like weird, jumpy or some shit.
Right. And again, but that, I mean, you think back in that movie, what was like that all caused by people's energy and shit? It was like, why is New York so filled with such assholes? Oh, it was like this fucking green, you know, pink ooze flowing through the cities. I mean, like you said, dude, that's Twitter, that's Instagram, that's fucking Facebook, it's Snapchat, it's like TikTok, all that shit, dude.
Well, and it's what's in all of us, right? Like, we all have like both those sides to us, but that's just like, all that shit's just like encouraging that to bubble up in everybody, where it's like, you don't really get much of a response for the good stuff. So it's not until you really start arguing with people and, like, you know, posting negative shit. From what I mean, right. I don't have it fall into it yet, luckily, but it seems like that's when you really get the big response, and that's when your adrenaline probably kicks in, and then you get an argument with somebody, and now you're like, you might just be sitting in your house, but, you know, your fucking heart beats up and you're doing something, you know? So I think that's people exactly. like probably really get a kick out of that. And I don't know. It sounds too anxiety ridden for me, to be honest with you.
Well, that's the thing, dude. It's like, how can somebody like just ride that out, dude? It's like all evening, dude. It's just like checking your phone. Oh. I mean, I've been there before too, man. You know, it's just, yeah. you know, and it's just, I don't know. You just kind of get to a point where you're just like, what the fuck am I doing, dude? Like, why? Right. I don't know when I don't think I feel like more of a piece of shit outside of like when I'm like fucking sitting, like you go on, you know, a trip or something, dude, and you're like sitting in the hotel and you're just sitting on your phone like all afternoon, dude.
Yeah.
All fucking afternoon, dude. And you're just like, what am I doing?
Like, yeah. You can feel it even when you're doing it. You're like, oh man, I'm fucking at the ocean and I'm on my phone. What the fuck am I doing? All right, 5 more minutes and then I'm enjoying the scenery. It's like, no, you shouldn't even bring it with you in the first. You're not missing out on anything. If a bomb drops, the sirens will go off and you'll hear about it. Other than that, nothing really matters that much.
Yeah, dude. It's really hard though, just to like center yourself like that all the time and like just be consciously aware of like your surroundings in that sense, you know, like be aware of the moment.
Yeah, I mean, that's the key, right? That really is. I mean, if nothing else, maybe all this shit has been a little bit of a reminder of that, since we kind of have to all, you know, look in ourselves for things to do and you know.
Even though I think a lot of people are like just internally like freaked out over that, dude. They're just like, yeah. What do you mean I'm gonna
a lot of people are having a hard time with it, it seems. Right. Judging on everything online and everything. I mean, and obviously, like, you know, it's nothing that other people haven't already said, but the fact that I mean, what are we, like 18 days out from this election, that it just all hits right at the same time. Everyone was already fucking crazy, and now it's like, now you got to be locked in an apartment with your whole family for 6 months. It's like, Jesus, perfect storm.
Are we only 18 days away? Like, holy shit.
Dude. I heard 19 yesterday.
Yeah. I mean, as we record this, dude, it's like, damn, dude, this year went by quick though, dude. Like,
I know,
this year went by really quick.
So crazy. And dude, that also just goes to show how fast, you know, I think Robert Kelly has a joke where he talks about, like, I have 36 at the time or whatever it was, but it's probably less. It was probably like 26 or 15 or whatever. He's like, I've got whatever, 26 summers left. Like, if I had $26, I would be poor. And I only have 26 summers, give or take, left in my life, or however old it was at the time. And just makes you, I mean, it is what it is.
You appreciate it.
Yeah. But you look back and like, all right, well, that was the summer of 2020, for better or worse. That's gone now.
Sucked, dude.
That one back.
you know, and it's kind of funny. We were talking about all the social media and jealousy. I will admit to one little bit of jealousy that I have seen, like, throughout the summer, dude. Anytime I saw anybody out on the lake or on the fucking water, dude, just like chilling out in their bathing suit and shit, I'm just like, fuck that person, dude, because I didn't get to do that shit at all. The only time I even had the chance to do it this year, I was fucking sick, dude. So it's Yeah, dude. It was just like, motherfucker, dude. And no, it wasn't fucking COVID. It was diarrhea, motherfucker.
You happy now? So I wasn't allowed in the lake.
Food poisoning, bitch.
You're welcome for not shitting in the lake.
Yeah, exactly, dude. I didn't taint the fucking lake.
I mean, I guess, they look fun for most of the people, but there was like a handful of people that died in the river this year, I think, right? Like, more than usual.
I don't know. Yeah, man, you're probably right, dude. Every year, the Yakima River always fucking has a lot. There was just a couple days ago, man, there was a lady that went missing, dude, and I honestly thought, she's dead. They found her on the fucking side of a mountain, dude, the next day, and I was like, thank God.
That she was alive?
She was alive.
Oh, that's good. I thought you meant they found the remains on the side of some coyote dragging up there or some shit. Good, at least.
This is my dinner. This is my dinner.
Fighting the sheep.
The sheriff comes up like, ah! Shoots it.
My dinner.
My dinner now.
I guess one of the groups is like a fucking, like, old folks home went like white water rafting or something, and it turned out about as well as you could expect.
Are you serious?
I think they lost two people or something. It's not funny, but goddamn, man, it's like,
that's where
like
was this worst. Was this here locally?
I think so earlier this summer. I'm sure I'm exaggerating, but it was something like that. I remember just thinking, like, you can't take a group of fucking 70-year-olds out on the river. I don't care how calm you think it is. It's just not.
Someone's got to make that call, Jay. You know, he's got to step in and be like, all right, guys, we need to calm down the White River rafting on this one, guys. We're gonna stay in.
Like, no. I just want to enjoy your golden years. We'll do something fun, but someone's got to put their foot down at the rafting.
Like, I got 4 summers left, Jim. Yeah. Let me do this.
That's all right. This is how I want to go. A Viking's funeral.
Right? Just let it go. Let me go.
Better than COVID. I'm probably pretty similar.
You'd rather drown than fucking drown in your food in your lungs.
Rough. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty similar. Pretty horrible either way, I guess.
Yeah. Well, I guess, you know, drowning, you're gone within minutes. Sitting in a hospital bed, I mean, you're gone it's within true. Days. And you don't got to suffer as much. So, I mean, if you're given a choice, if you're like, man, you're going to die, how do you want to die? It's like, well, let's just go with the drown.
If those are the only two options, then yeah, at least I'd rather be outside. You're like, oh well, at least right. less vision or whatever is of the sky and not hospital fucking ceiling, fucking rain stains or whatever on the tile.
That would be the worst way to go. To just be like cooped up in a fucking hospital bed. Not even like I don't know. I remember like no one time like we've had a couple of family members like die like that. The only one that I was ever like present for though was like my Aunt Mary. And like, yeah, we're just like, you know, family comes in, says goodbye. It's like, they're not even fucking saying, like, you know, they're there.
Oh,
and
yeah.
They can hear. You just know that. Cause like by the time, like all the people that are able to come in, you know, I don't know. Just like, at least with her, dude, it was like, you know, once everybody came in that you knew it was going to come, that's when she passed away. Dude. You know, it's like, you know, I don't know.
It's always better if they can go home. That's why, was it hospice or whatever?
Yeah.
It's so cool. I think it's like, non-profit. I don't even know. I don't think it's even like a government agency or anything. It's just people that it's like help make people like that
feel
comfortable
better.
At home. Because like, no one wants to fucking. No one likes being in a hospital when they're healthy. Who wants to fucking spend their last days in a goddamn hospital?
Man. Yeah, I know, dude. It's like my dad, man. It's like, you know, as sad as it was when he died, bro, I'd rather go out that way with a fucking heart attack. 30 seconds later, you're gone.
Yeah, dude. That seems like if it's got to be, if you had a list of things and it was the drowning in a river hospital or just like the Widowmaker, sign me up for that one for sure. I mean, there's pros and cons for like your family and stuff, I guess. Right. But
whoever's got to find you. I mean, that's not a fun situation.
Scrape you off the road afterwards.
Yeah, shout out Kyle. Like, find my dad dead.
Not the best. That's not the best role to play.
It was the worst day of my life, Kevin.
Yeah, but it was quick. What are you going to do?
What are you going to do? I should have stayed home. I knew it. He's like, nah, I don't think you really would have done much. I'm glad you went and got an education that day.
Yeah, this wasn't not much to do. This
wasn't meant to be. Yeah, finally happened.
Yes, inevitable.
Oh no, my dad had like 3 heart attacks before that, dude. Like,
oh really?
I remember one of my earliest memories was like living in Bellingham, and like I don't even know. I probably said this on the fucking podcast before, but like my earliest memory was like I was sitting out like watching cartoons, like, you know, it was like 1989 or some shit. I'm like looking, there's like a commercial for some ice cream toy. I'm like, Dad, I want the fucking ice cream toy for Christmas. He's like, comes out. I just remember him like holding his heart, just like sitting in the chair, just like looking back. He's like, fucking. And I just like, that's all. Then I remember like the ambulance coming in, like carrying him out, and like us seeing him at the hospital and shit. But like, you think about it though, dude, it's all like, you know, hell, I mean, it's all driven by his own actions. I mean, it was all the booze, the salt, the shitty fucking diet, no exercise. Like, well, what do you expect is going to fucking happen?
That'll do it. I expect to have a couple more decades at least.
Yeah, I know, dude. Dude, my dad be pushing like fucking 70 right now. He went out at the ripe age of 53, dude. You know,
oh, yeah.
Like, he'd be like that's pushing 70, like 68, 69 at this point.
That could be worse. Mine made it to 50, so he had 3 years on my dad. Shocking that both our dads died young given our own. But that's a good example too, like you were saying earlier. So it's like, it's all about where you came from. So it's easy to be like, well, I'm not doing as good as this person or I've, you know, sure, my life sucks or whatever, but it's like, but where'd you come from? I mean, my dad died at 50. My great-great-grandpa was like an Irish immigrant who had, you know, was just like a cartoon character of a drunken like spousal piece of shit. So it's like, considering where we've came from, we're all doing pretty good.
Doing all right.
Yeah, I got a roof over my head. I'm not drunk every day. I mean, I'm doing all right.
You got some days in between, dude.
Yeah, I put a couple days in between here and there. Could be worse. I don't have a family, but at least I'm not supporting my family or whatever. You know.
Yeah, you support yourself, man. Yeah, man. I mean, that's like half the fight right there, dude. Just maintaining and holding a fucking job. I mean, like, it's not the hardest thing, but it's like also it's kind of hard. You know, you got to get up every day. I mean, for the amount of people I know that like constantly are cycling through jobs and shit, it's like, well, you know, I don't know. Maybe your commitment's not as good. You know, I don't know.
I've known so many people that, yeah, like I can't imagine for whatever weird, like everything else, like wrong with me and stuff. Like there's that weird, like, I guess work ethic or whatever it is that gets put in you, because I've known people who just do like the no call, no show thing to jobs that I could never imagine. They just be like, I'm not going to work. It's just like,
I would call in, but whatever.
I could see. But I have people that wouldn't even call in. They just are friends that like wouldn't even, they just be like, I'm not going to work. It's like, damn. And they just, I guess
like, how long have you had this job? I had 3 months, whatever.
Yeah, guess I'll get another one. It's like, I can't, part of me wishes I could be that guy, but
right.
Yeah. I mean, like you said, whatever, for better or worse, you just get up I'd be more of like the miner or like the old, like, you know, cowhand that goes and spend his money at the saloon if it was like the 1800s, right? It's like you just work all day like a fucking filthy slob and then go spend your money on some cheap booze, you know?
Shit, dude. That's like, man, that's like, fuck, dude. When you really think about like the difference in like, you know, 100 years ago, you know, comparing it to now, dude, it's like, yeah, I mean that's the way it's always been, dude. I mean, you get up, you go to work, you know.
Yeah, slightly different jobs, slightly different vices, but ultimately not a whole lot different, really.
Right? You know, it's not a whole lot different, dude. I mean,
play darts and visit the whorehouse, and we play video games and go online for whatever.
Go online, whatever's going porn, on dude.
On there. Yeah.
Who's got it easier though, man?
Oh, well, yeah, we definitely have it easier for sure. Yeah.
It's like, we're just fucking spoiled. The level
of violence. Like, I was thinking about the other day, like, I'm glad that it doesn't exist anymore, but like, fights and just fist fights and just violence was just an everyday occurrence for people 100 years ago. Like, it just wasn't a thing, especially for like young men growing up and stuff. I've never really been in like a all out like fist fight and stuff. And I bet not very many people could say that like 100 years ago. Like, you're going to fight with people. You're going to be, and even in today in some places, you know, there's no way around it.
It was, and even as when we were kids, man, like I remember getting into scuffles and shit, dude. And like, you'd see fist fights, and I don't know, you wouldn't like really see repercussions, you know. It kind of, like you said, you know, it was kind of like a common occurrence, dude.
So, yeah, it was more normal. Now it's called like violence. Back then it was like, two guys. I mean, I'm not excusing it, because I don't think it is good. It depends, you know.
It builds character, dude. Nah, we don't have to pussyfoot around it. It can definitely build character, man. I mean, if you got a scuffle, dude, like with people, and like, you got to defend yourself. I mean, that's building something up at least.
Oh yeah, for sure. It's such a fine line too, though, right? Because it definitely, like, to a certain extent would build character if it's like two equal foes that just maybe had an argument and they're going at it. But you would also, back then, you know, that's like real bullying back then, where you'd have someone smaller that would literally get the shit kicked out of them just for being like small or different or something.
Dude, that's like my whole entire like middle school existence, dude. Like, I used to be this short little kid with long hair. But I used to get, dude, like the group of friends I had, like they would just like fuck with me, dude, just because I was small, dude, and they could beat me up.
Why didn't you cut your hair? You should have fit in. You should have conformed.
I did. It's a funny thing, though. I did cut my hair like in the beginning of the year, dude. And I remember the lady that cut my hair thought I was a little girl, dude. I was what the fuck?
Come on, bitch. Lady.
Don't assume my identity. Who do I identify? I got a penis
and long luxurious hair. That's right? My business.
Yeah, that's my business. But dude, I used to get picked on all the fucking time, dude. And like, I don't know, dude, like, would I like not want myself to go through that, you know, looking back on it? You know, yeah, probably not. But at the same time, I mean, like, going through hardships, dude, that's how you become a better human being, dude. You learn lessons from whatever, you know, things are put in front of you, you know, whether you're fucking 12 or whether you're fucking 55 or whatever, dude. You know,
right.
So you're always learning. You're always trying to be better and shit. And like, yeah, you know, now we know as adults. So yeah, probably not the best idea to go punch somebody in the fucking face, dude. But damn, as Portland's showing us, dude, some of those people don't give a fuck, dude. And we'll just take somebody out, you know, it's just, it's ridiculous, dude. It's like, I don't know, dude. Like, It's scary. It's scary to watch somebody get punched in the face just now with like brain trauma and brain injuries and all that shit that we're now all aware of. Thanks to Chris Benoit, you know, like pushing that CTE, you know,
in everyone's face. Yeah, dude. I mean, yeah, it's such a fine, like we said, again, the, you got, it's a happy medium between not maybe not punched, but not, yeah, not suffering any hardships and then suffering too much where you go over the line and you're like, you know, scarred
like
for life.
You're beating your wife like 10 years later.
You're right. Like, you're having traumatic flashbacks. This is for all the
trauma I had yeah. as a kid.
You're talking down to me. I'm a man. I'm a strong man.
That's I'm a strong.
I know. Like some weird people.
But well, you do see some of like those guys that are really short. You really do see that short man syndrome where they just got puff up, dude. Like,
oh,
what's
yeah.
up, buddy? What's up? And like, you know, like, Beefcake. It's like, yeah, get out, move on.
But like you said, at the end of the day, like ultimately what you're learning from that, so long as it doesn't go too far and horribly psychologically scar you, is how to deal with assholes. And there are going to be assholes in the world when you grow up, and you can't always fight them. Hopefully, you know, you got to be able to really understand what. There's some people that don't know how to, and we see a lot of that now, probably like in workplaces and stuff where it's like, when you deal with just different level of bullying and or different levels of bullying and like just general assholes in school and stuff, you understand. It's like, okay, maybe sometimes I might have to fight if it comes down to it. A lot of times I could walk away. Other times maybe I say something, maybe I don't, you know, like right. You do have to learn how to deal with all sorts of different type of people. At least you did before, you know, the Chinese style social credit system or whatever we're going to have here soon. When you had free speech and stuff, you had to deal with assholes.
When you had free speech, you had to deal with assholes. Now we just deal with the government.
Yeah. Now you just, yeah. Aren't allowed to say, now people just aren't allowed to say asshole things, or I guess they are, but it's got to be a little more sneaky, I suppose.
Yeah. As long as it's approved by the government, dude, I don't right. care. So there's going to be a proven like a government mandate when it comes to, you know, what you can talk yep. down upon, you know?
I mean, kind of. There's like approved like victims. Like, okay, these approved people are allowed to be made fun of, yeah. and no one else is allowed to be made. You know, it is kind of weird when it comes to that.
Yeah, dude. So can't make fun of the Chinese. Can't make fun of black people. Can't make fun of fucking Mexicans.
Yeah,
you can make fun of Jews.
Not really. Yeah, there's not a lot. You make fun of Trump, and that's about it at this point.
Yeah, right.
We have this one. That's what the president's going to be in the future. The one designated person everyone's allowed to make fun of.
Oh god, dude, they're just they're like Trump's extreme dictator, dude. They're like they found the fountain of youth. He's gonna live forever, and yeah, he's totally taking dictator powership here in the United States, guys. He's not leaving yep. the White House.
We don't even notice. It's just like shit. Just gets so progressively worse until like 40 years from now. Like, wait a second. Is Trump still in charge? What the fuck?
We just forget, dude. We're just like, wait a minute. What do you mean politics, dude? We've had enlightenment for the last 30 years.
Yeah, he's wearing that fucking mask like that old man in the Mad Max remake.
Oh, like, God.
Driving Air Force One around, killing people.
Oh, man. I never even – was that Fury Road or whatever?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have it because I bought it for like $3 at Walmart, but like nice. I never watched it.
I'd say it's probably worth a watch. I certainly saw it once in the theater, but definitely cool. Like, I don't even think, I think its big thing was it wasn't, I was going to say special effects, but I think it's like real effects or whatever they call it. Cause they really got like people doing crazy shit, hanging off of cars and stuff like that.
I respect that. I respect the fuck it. Like anything like less than CGI, dude. Like,
oh yeah, fuck,
dude. I was watching like today. Have you ever watched any of the Phantasm movies?
No, but I've been watching more horror movies, and I've seen them on there, and I remember thinking like, what the fuck, is this a weird old man?
Tall man, is he the
Antichrist, or is he the devil, or what's the
deal? He's kind of like a demon in a sense. Like he's like this like shape-shifting demon that can like trans, like he never dies. It's this thing, he's like comes back from like all these alternate realities and stuff. So anytime they kill him after, like, you know, every time that they fucking killed him, he comes back in the next movie, right? So
interesting.
The first one's good. The second one's good. The third one's good. Huh? The fourth one, I could even argue, wasn't that bad. Like, that's still seemed good. Like it was a Phantasm movie, dude. But then come 2016, they released Phantasm 5. Dude.
Takes a turn.
It takes a turn for the worse, bro.
That's like, unfortunate.
I don't know. It just had that type, like the way, I don't know, like the way technology looks like for movies that like are very kind of like smaller budget, you would consider they're definitely like more independent or whatever. Mm-hmm. Like there's a way they do the special effects, like, I don't know, like, or it just, it looks like, it doesn't look bad, you know, but it's just, I don't know. It's just, I don't know, with acting and just like the story, it was like, this is shitty, dude. Like Brandon Allen always would tell me, dude, you know, Phantasm 5 is something that should never have existed. Like it should just be completely washed away from the history of, you know, video production, dude. Like it proves no point of like existing. Like there's no reason for it to be here. It's, but with that being said, you should watch the Phantasm series.
Yeah, I'll check them out. Actually, it's funny because I was going to say, I spent like the first 6 months playing video games of this whole thing, and just this like last month, I've been watching more movies and stuff because my girl likes Halloween, so we've been watching like going back. She never saw like the original Halloween or Friday the 13th. So we've been going back and watching like all those old ones these last couple weeks, and they're pretty good. I was surprised. I hadn't seen them in a while, and
they still hold up, dude. Like they really especially do. Halloween, dude. Like dude, I don't know, Halloween 1, dude. That first one, man. Like I'd say it's probably the best one.
I liked it a lot, although I could see why people wouldn't, especially nowadays, because it's super slow compared to like shit that you're getting nowadays, or certainly what you were getting, like, you know, by the time Halloween became just a complete straight up like slasher movie or whatever. But I like it. I my favorite part of horror movies is the start where nothing's happening yet, where everyone's just like hanging out and everything's still like happy and good. Like that to me is fun. And this one is like basically an hour of that before there's a little bit of like creepiness because you see like Michael Myers coming, but a lot of it is just like Jamie Lee Curtis hanging out with their friends.
Yeah, smoking weed.
Yeah, exactly.
You're literally smoking weed. They roll up. They're like, oh, no, it's my dad. It's like, dude, you could have just driven away. Like, you didn't have to stop. You pulled up to
your cop dad. Exactly. Yeah. Well, that one's weird, too, because, I mean, it's funny to me, but ultimately, Michael Myers, well, not really, but basically, if she was smart, was foiled by a metal coat hanger. At the end, when she's hiding in the closet, she unravels a metal coat hanger, just kind of half-heartedly jabs it at his face, and he falls down flat on his back and drops the knife. If she was smart, she could have picked up the knife right there and just, like, jammed it into his forehead. And there, movie over. Fucking whole series over. This big bad man was killed with a metal coat hanger, essentially.
They should have just hired you on, dude. I mean, the fuck, dude, people would have walked out satisfied with that. And
like, you know, like, what the fuck?
Strong conclusion, dude. Like, there's no way that guy's coming back.
I also like that it was like 125 minutes long, which that's more. I hate these fucking three. If you're in the right mood and I have like 2 days to watch it, I don't mind like a long movie. But man, it seems like everything's at least 2 hours nowadays. I like just a short little hour and a half horror movie.
There's nothing wrong with an hour and a half film, dude. Like, I like podcasts that are longer, but like, yeah, like movies, it really depends. I mean, like, I don't know. The Irishman, I guess, is like the movie that came out within the last year. I mean, that was like, what, 4 hours fucking long, dude?
Yeah, I never saw that.
Saw The Irishman, dude?
I could never start it. I've been meaning to, but that would take me a fucking 4 hour movie. It would take me like a month to watch.
I sat down, I watched it all in one night, dude. I fucking smoked a shit ton of fucking weed. And yeah, man, I mean, comparing it to Goodfellas and like, you know, Casino and all that shit, I mean, it's fun, but at the same time, I don't know. I don't think it's as good as everybody fucking says it was. I mean, you know, call it blasphemy, whatever, Brandon Allen, whatever.
I mean, I can't, how could it possibly, it couldn't possibly hold up to, I mean, it is what it is, I'm sure, but it couldn't possibly hold up to like Goodfellas. I mean, that's just the humor and stuff in Goodfellas. You'd watch it over and over and find something different every time you watch it, you know?
Well, Joe Pesci's character in The Irishman, he's like, in The Irishman specifically, I mean, I forget exactly who, he plays some sort of mob boss, you know, but like, he's not, it's not Joe Pesci, dude. It's completely like different.
Yeah. It's not what he plays in Casino and Goodfellas, right? He's just playing
his normal stereotype.
It's unfair for us to pigeonhole him there, but goddamn, everyone wants to fucking say, especially because he hasn't been in anything in a while, as far as I know. Like,
they brought him out of retirement for that, dude. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. He got brought out of retirement for The Irishman.
Well, I guess he should just be glad he didn't get fucking punched in the head like Rick Moranis or whatever his name
is. Oh my gosh, dude, what is up with Rick Moranis getting punched in the face?
As soon as he's out of retirement, that's crazy.
I know, when he comes back for that, like, he came back for that stupid fucking commercial with Ryan Reynolds, dude. It's like, first off, Ryan Reynolds looked like a fucking complete idiot with those glasses, dude.
I didn't even see the commercial, but I heard that he was in a commercial, and I think he's supposed to be in a movie too. I forget what one, some sort of remake or something, I think.
Shit, speaking of fucking remakes there, dude. I mean, they're coming out with that new Ghostbusters movie, dude. That looked pretty fun. There's one thing COVID fucked up, dude. I wanted to see that movie so bad this summer, dude.
Is there a trailer for it out?
Oh, yeah.
So what is it like? So they're actually bringing back the dudes?
It's the son of Ivan Reitman. I think that was the original
dad, right? Yeah.
No, I think Ivan Reitman's still alive.
Oh, no, yeah.
Harold Ramis is dead.
Yeah, yeah.
So like it's his son that's like produced and directed this this new one. And like the way they shot the original like teaser trailer, like it came out like I don't know, like fucking at the beginning of the year, maybe even before that, like a year ago as of now, you know? And like it was like they used like original, like I forget exactly what it was, but they were shooting it more like it would have been shot in 1984 when the original one was filmed. So it was like they were really going back to practical effects in terms of the way the movie was. Nice. And the story was written, I think, I want to say Dan Aykroyd had a, like, if he didn't write it, he had a very heavy influence in regards to the production of the film. And it's more about it's an ode to the story, the original story, you know, with
nice.
Your Bankman and, you know, fucking all that shit, dude. So it's going to be a lot fucking better than the one that came out a couple years ago, dude.
I never even saw that one. Did you end up seeing that?
Yeah, dude. I mean, I have a digital copy of it. Yeah. I mean, like, I don't hate it because of, like, you know, and I don't hate it for, like, everybody's like, oh, it's because they were girls. It's like, that's right, so stupid, dude. Just, you know, it's just like, I don't know. Like, it was just like they were trying too hard, dude. They're like, oh, I take that back. You know, I think it was because they were girls. They're like, basically, we're going to do Ghostbusters, but with girls. And I was like, I don't know. It's not as good as, like, you know, what they rolled out in, like, 1984, dude.
Well, it's just any time that they need to resort to, like, stunt casting or like something. It's like, well, how about you do Ghostbusters and you just write it well? And if that includes female roles, then all the better. But you don't you don't need to structure it around, hey, all women. It's like, okay, is it written well? Is it funny? Is it a good movie? Like, you got to be pretty stupid to just buy into that. But I think that was kind of more of like a kid's movie, I guess, which I guess, I don't know. Is the original Ghostbusters a kid's movie? I think
the second one was more geared to kids, but dude, I mean, like that first one, dude, scary, dude. Like,
yeah.
Opening scene in the library, dude. Like, that's a scary, but, like, even I showing it to my kids, like, now I was like, fuck, I don't know if I should have showed that to them.
But I remember watching it as a kid, but then when I went back and watched it as an adult, there is a lot of, like, especially that first one, there's a lot of talking and stuff. So maybe like an older kid, right? Like 12 or something.
Yeah, I think you probably want to be a little bit older. But dude, I remember watching it as a kid. And like,
oh yeah,
I'm not that fucked up. Even though my dad showed me fucking Nightmare on Elm Street, he showed me Part 5, which is like the worst one.
I shit myself every time I go into a library. But other than that, I'm fine.
I know, dude. And then, like, have you seen the new It? Have you seen any of those?
Yeah, I saw those. They were okay. I remember. I don't know what my problem was. I don't like criticizing movies because I feel like people do that too much and stuff. But at the same time, I'm rarely like blown away from any of that. I can't. There's a very small handful like It. Like, I remember thinking like, yeah, that was okay. It wasn't like great. It wasn't horrible.
I thought the second one, like, I really enjoyed the second one, and I was pretty fucking disappointed that like everybody trashed it so fucking hard.
Yeah, I remember thinking I didn't watch that one for a while until after. Mm-hmm. It came out. I remember I had heard that, and then I watched it, and I remember thinking, yeah, that's not as bad as people said.
Yeah, man. Like, it was more close to the book, too, dude. I mean, they did a way better job of following the book in the second one than they did on the first one, dude. That first one was just, like, popcorn horror flick, dude, which was fun. I mean, it was still, like, Skarsgård, I thought, does a really good job as Pennywise, and, like, I don't know. I mean, everybody's always says, like, Tim Curry, you know, that's Pennywise, which – I mean, the miniseries was fun, especially as a kid looking back, dude. But I mean, like, I don't think it really holds up today, you know?
No, if you go back and watch it, it's certainly, I mean, it's fun, like you said, especially if you remember it as a kid, but it's not, like, amazing when you go back and watch it. I think people just have fond memories of it as a kid, you know?
Right. I mean, as a kid, dude, that scared the shit out of me, dude. Like,
yeah.
Kind of like, dude, like, I don't know. I mean, Doink the Clown, dude. I mean, fuck. Yeah. Nightmares.
I wonder if, it's probably right around the same time, actually. So it was a popular book, too, around, I think, the early to mid-90s.
Yeah, I think the book came out in the mid-80s, but then the miniseries came out in, like, 1990. Yeah, it was, like, 1985, I think. 85 or 86 was when the book came out. Which, that book, man, if you haven't read that book, dude, it's such a great book.
I was going to say, it's like stupid whenever anyone says this, but I guess it's a little less pretentious or whatever if you're talking about Stephen King, because it sounds like popcorn books. But I remember like loving that book so much yeah. that even anything else after it, it's like not fair, but it's just so, it's hard to compare, you know?
Yeah. I remember going on a trip to Anaheim, dude, and just like the whole time, dude, like, you know, we had like, you know, passes to Disneyland, dude. It's like, oh shit, living the dream, 17. You know, you wish you'd be 17 and go to the fucking Disneyland, dude. But the whole time, dude, I'm just like staying in the hotel room, you know, it's like, this is pre-cell phone. So I'm just like, got my nose in a book, dude, you know,
which nice.
Probably even then, you know, people then compared it, like, just like, what are you going to do? Waste your whole time reading a book? What the fuck? Go nerd. Enjoy life, fucking nerd.
Well, you know? Obviously weren't bullied enough, or you would have had that beaten out of you, your love for books as well.
Dude. I, you know, man, that's the thing, dude. I don't see my kids reading as much as, you know, I did as a kid, dude. Like,
yeah,
I read a lot. You know, looking back, dude, I read a lot, dude. I always read the newspaper from very young age, dude. Like very young age, I always read. I always paid attention to what was going on in the news, and like, you know, it was just like Goosebumps. Like, you know, once I got old enough, dude, I started reading Stephen King books. Which, like, honestly, like, I outside of that, dude, like, I don't really read a lot of nonfiction, dude. Like, which one's nonfiction? I always fiction is fiction fake. Made up.
Yeah. Oh, I know. Yeah, fiction's made up. Fiction's
okay, so, like, up. I don't read a lot of fiction. Like, I read a lot of nonfiction with, like, biographies. And, like,
oh, yeah.
I read a lot of biographies now. That's, like, pretty much all I ever read.
Nice. What's you read any good one lately about anybody?
I did, dude. COVID, like, drove me back to reading. I hadn't read a book, dude, in, like, probably a good couple years. And I read Robert Englund's fucking autobiography.
Is that the Freddy Krueger guy?
Freddy Krueger, dude. it was kind of boring.
I'm thinking you're gonna say like JFK or fucking goddamn William Thomas Jefferson or some shit.
No, dude. I read a lot of whatever like interests me, dude. So it's like horror shit, you know. Nice. So like I bought a Doug Stanhope book, which I think I bought his second book, which that was actually a pretty fun read.
Which one's that?
Ah, fuck. Like, something about fame.
Yeah, I'm not even sure. But, yeah, I've read one or two of his. Like, Digging Up Mother, I think I read. Is that one of them?
I've heard the bit that he does, the stand-up bit that he does about his mom fucking dying, dude.
Yeah.
That's so good. It's such a good bit, dude. Fuck, man. Speaking of, like, stand-up, dude, I've been getting hardcore into, like, just fucking – I've been really trying not to pay attention to the news at all, honestly, dude. So I've been, like – I've basically just been watching movies, like, horror films, basically, and, like, listening to stand-up albums. And, like, so, like, I fucking – dude, Dan Soder's that Son of Gary stand-up special that he had for HBO.
Yeah.
Holy shit, dude, that was great.
Yeah, Soder is great. That was hilarious. He's one of the best young ones out there right now, for sure.
Yeah, man.
I think he's still working and touring, from what I've heard. Right here, a little bit off like Bonfire and stuff, and it sounds like he's still doing dates here and there where they allow him to. Yeah.
Yeah, man. He's definitely one of those guys. Like, do you think he's playing theaters now at this point, or is he'd just be on the cusp of something like that, right? Like, not.
Yeah, either. I think he's one of the guys that like really, you know, got hit from this whole thing, because he would probably be getting pretty close, especially like with the HBO special and stuff. But I don't know if anyone's doing theaters right now.
Well, yeah, no, you're right. I mean, obviously they're all doing clubs and shit, dude. Yeah. So, but I mean, like, I guess like, okay, pre-COVID though, you know, it's like,
yeah, you'd probably be right on the cusp of it, I imagine. Maybe. Yeah, I guess who knows for sure. But I mean, you would think him and Norman and some of those other guys that were kind of hitting with some of the specials and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's like, damn, dude. I mean, Mark Norman's fucking special, dude. Like the Out to Lunch, the one that he dropped on YouTube, dude. That was another great one, dude.
Yeah, and was a Joe List
had a really good one
this whole time. That's a good one.
Did you see,
Bill Burr on SNL?
I did. I actually just today, dude. I watched like at least two, three of the sketches that he did.
I didn't see any of the sketches. I heard some of the monologue, but I haven't been able to just been too lazy to watch it all so far. Mm-hmm. Was it? Did you see the monologue? Because I guess that's what a lot of people are talking about.
I did.
It sounded pretty good. It sounded like nothing like groundbreaking necessarily, but it's cool that he's just able to go and do his thing on SNL in prime time, or not prime time, but SNL.
Yeah, dude. I think it's a really big deal that, you know, Bill Burr's on. I don't know what that says, dude. I mean, you got Joe Rogan going to Spotify, Bill Burr on fucking Saturday Night Live. I mean, I feel like, I don't know. I don't know, man. It's just like those guys have like, yeah, I mean, they're at that like mainstream level. Well, I mean, I suppose
that's
the
thing. If you're big enough, you can get away with just about it. You can get away with still being like those guys, right? Like right. if, because Joe Rogan, even Burr at this point, is kind of uncancelable. Because, you know, Rogan especially, I mean, especially after the Spotify deal, like when you get $100 million or whatever it is, that you can do whatever the fuck you want.
Allegedly. Allegedly yeah. $100 million.
Well, someone else alleged that it was even more than that. Someone said closer to like two when you're talking about all the advertising and shit like that. Which is, I mean, that's crazy. Where we, I mean, I remember when podcasts didn't exist, like we've talked about before. I remember going to work at night and having to listen to like the radio, the AM radio. So it was like the Mariners or AM talk or whatever. There was, they literally just didn't even exist. And now he just got $100 million or whatever to fucking just talk in his basement. Or
where that shit began, dude. I mean, like, you go back and listen to, I went through, like, I don't know, it was probably about like, I don't know, 6 months ago or something. I went through and listened to a lot of like the older episodes that he did. And yeah, mm-hmm. man, I mean, it's a completely different show, dude. It's a completely different animal at this point. But it's, yeah, I mean, like, cause again, dude, it's just like, you know, people are just talking, dude. But like, to me, like, podcasting is always just, it's, that's, to me, that's like real life. If you're doing it right, it's real life. You know, you're literally putting yourself out there. You're just, you're fucking having conversations. You're just having real moments with people. And, it's really hard to go back to like watching your average, you know, cable TV, dude. Like, yeah, I feel insulted now, dude, when I go watch like cable TV and I'm just like, yeah, this is all just bullshit. It's all fake bullshit. You know?
Yep. Or like commercials and sitcoms and stuff. Yeah. It's like, you motherfuckers think I'm really stupid, don't you? You fucking think I'm going to fall for this? You got a room full of people laughing, so you think I'm going to think it's funny? Or you got some pretty lady telling me to buy this car or something? It's just like, man, they really, advertisers and stuff, like, really think lowly of people. And maybe they're right, but goddamn, yeah, you get away from just like that. Right. That small window. And yeah, you just, like you said, you start listening to like real people have real conversations about stuff. And then like, you go back to that, even the fact that they're not allowed to swear is so, it's just like such a weird, bizarre thing. Not even that you'd want to. I mean, oftentimes people go hours at a time without swearing, but if it just happens that come up in conversation, the idea that nope, you bleep that out, or that's not allowed. It's like, what are we even doing? What is this? It's so outdated.
You got to protect the children, Jay. You got to protect the children.
It's like, it's such a perfect example of like the complete lack of like nuance or context or anything, where it's like, oh, we were having a 2-hour conversation about all sorts of different stuff. I guess, yeah, did someone say fuck once? Sorry about that. It's like, no, you said it. It's over. Cancel it. Or, you know, or we can't air that episode or whatever it is. Or that radio guy's fired. It's like, what? It's not even what it's about. What were you even listening for, you know?
It's like, now these guys, like, dude, like, these guys are, like, like, if you have, like, a job, like, out there, if you're out there in the public, dude, like, you know, it's like what the guy that does the Seattle, the Seahawks, what's his fucking name?
Oh, Steve Grable or something?
No, it's like Dory Monson.
Oh, right.
He's like a conservative radio host over there, like in Seattle, dude. So he's like,
is he?
Public enemy number one.
Okay. I've grown up hearing his name and knowing that he was on the radio and that he was kind of affiliated with the Seahawks, but I never knew that he was an actual conservative talk host.
He would do the pregame, I should say. I should preface that. He used to do the pregame.
He get fired because of
Dude.
I didn't hear about any of that.
Okay, so they had the governor, you know, debate here last week, again, you know, dating this episode. So Culp and Inslee are going at it, you know, Lauren Culp, he's the Republican candidate.
Okay.
Laid it in for anybody that's outside Washington State, you know?
I'm in the state and I didn't even know that happened. I've never even heard of I just try to pay such little attention to any of this.
Well, so they had this debate and, like, you know, Inslee's going off about how, like, you know, the way Washington State's handled this COVID-19 you know, dilemma is based on science. He's like, science. And so Dory Monson, like, you know, and again, you know, this is the argument of, you know, people on the, you know, on the other side, man. And, you know, they're just like, well, science, you know, you have science. Okay. So we're going by science. And, well, I don't know, you have your Y chromosome, your X chromosome, whatever, dude, but you can legally walk into the, you know, the state capitol and change your sex from female to male or whatever. Right. Well, I mean, some people would say, you know, would argue that's not true science, but yet, right. You know, that's what's accepted in society today. And that's, you know, that's fine, man. That's fine. You know, I'm just, sure. You know, don't kill the messenger here, but so fucking Dory Monson puts out a tweet saying this,
right?
Fucking everybody's like, yes, piece of bootlicking piece of shit, you know? It's like fucking tore him apart. He got fired, dude.
Oh no. Yeah. So they took the Seahawks away from him, the Seahawks pregame show.
It's a chick now, dude, because I was listening to it on the radio this last week. And yeah, dude, it's a chick now that they have hosting, which I think would be an appropriate replacement in 2020.
Yeah, I mean, it has to be at this point. You can't replace him with another Dory Monson type. That's too bad. I mean, how long has he been doing that? So
since like 2002 or some shit.
Okay, so I mean, yeah, so a good 20 years almost. But yeah, I mean, that's the unfortunate thing nowadays, which is so weird because it's not like, does that really affect anyone's enjoyment of the Seahawks pregame show? Like, those two things aren't even related.
Well, I mean, you know, it's all related in 2020, man. I mean, like, everything's, unfortunately, you know, I don't know. That's why I stay out of politics, dude. That's why I don't talk about religion. That's why I don't talk about any of that shit, dude. Just because, like, you know, it's not just because I don't want to get attacked for my viewpoints or anything. I just, fucking, what's the point, dude? We talked about it earlier, dude, about like, you know, being in the moment, you know, and like truly trying to, you know, appreciate, you know, your life and stuff. And like, you know, we're, you know, not trying to be all fucking stressed out, dude. And it's just like, it seems like, you know, what's the fucking word? Identity politics, right?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It's just too much, dude. You put too much effort into it, and I'm just like, nah, man, I'm good. You know?
Yeah, I mean, it's everything now. It's you're not allowed to just kind of dip your toe into it a little bit and be like, oh, what's going on? Or it's just like you have to pick a side, and then we're fighting to the death with that other side. Right. It's like, oh, wait, what? Yeah. It's like you're talking about like turn of the century. It's like that movie, Gangs in New York. Or like, as soon as you show up, you're like, or I guess it's like prison, which I think we talked about before. Like, as soon as you show up, you already have a gang that you could be with, or you could try to be by yourself. Good luck with that, because you'll just be like, you know, raped to death by somebody somewhere. So it's like, you have no choice. Or it's just like, you pick a side. A lot of times the side's picked for you. And then it's a fight to the death on whether it's in jail or on Twitter. And it's like,
Twitter, I know. No, it's like, that's the modern day, like, it's just, again, you know, just you have a differentiating opinion, dude. People just like, I don't know, there's no account for reason. It feels like it's again, it's like my way or the highway. And like, I have a problem with that, dude. I just feel like there's always like middle ground in regards to whatever an issue is. Like, there's always
truth, especially when you turn the computers off and go into real life, and it's like, no one at the grocery store is coming. Well, I'm okay. Maybe some people, but most of the people at the grocery store or anywhere else you go, your neighborhood walking down the street with their kids, they have no interest in getting in a yelling match with somebody. Even if they see someone else on the street, they're going to be like nice to them, and they're going to just try to have a nice interaction with them. 90% of people, at least.
Yeah.
But there's something about going online that just make you just fucking put your boxing gloves on and you just want to go to war with people, man. It's just not, I don't understand it, dude.
Like,
have you heard, there's the classic like AI problem or like cautionary tale of like, if you're not careful, you could program an AI to you think you're just programming it to make paper clips, but unless you tell it not to destroy the earth making all the paper clips it can, it'll just keep making paper clips. So like, if it runs out of metal, it'll start like, you know, using the factory, and if it runs out of the factory, it'll start using people, and it'll make people, you know, because all it knows is to make paper clips. It's like, it's almost like that's what happened on social media. We're like, let's just make a little AI algorithm to show people stuff that they like to engage with. What could go wrong? And it turns out that leads to civil war.
That's a good point. Yeah.
People like just the worst of them. It's like, well, people like to interact with things they hate, so I guess we'll just keep feeding them things they hate. And it's like, well, no, they didn't take into account what that might actually do to people's like fucking mental health and shit.
I know, dude. It's bad, dude. It's bad. It just, again, man, I just can't get into this like identity politics bullshit. Dude. I just can't take one side or the other and just be like, you know, hey, man, you know, this is the way it is.
I'm like the Quakers for war. Conscientious objector when it comes to all that shit. Mm-hmm. Where it's just like, nope, let's talk about things that we agree on. Let's talk about things we like. You like cats? Yeah, I like cats.
I like cats,
what's,
dude.
What's your favorite cat? Let's talk Speaking about of cats, that.
I got a new cat.
Oh, yeah. How is your new cat doing? Dude, I was going to ask you.
I haven't even talked about him on the podcast yet. Like, his name's Max, dude.
Max, huh?
Yeah, nice. Dude. So, like, we ended up, the way we ended up getting him was, like, through Jessica's, one of her coworkers here. Like, they, like, her sister, which we thought her sister was local, you know, here in town. Like, was like, oh, our cat just had cats. And, like, somehow we got offered a cat. It was my wife who was actually like, hey, you know, was like the one that brought it up. And like, she fucking hates cats. So I think secretly down, dude, she really does like cats. Cause like, she really,
they grow on you.
Yeah. Like when Stanley died, dude, like it fucking hurt her just as much as it hurt me, dude.
And she doesn't show it. She's got a tough exterior, but dude, she's tough, dude. Sorry, Morden, Stanley's death in the middle of the night. You come out and she's just looking at his bowl.
Got a single tear coming down. Like, yep. Gonna wrap this one up. Put it away.
You little son of a bitch.
but so anyway, like she showed me a picture and I was like, yeah, let's, you know, because I knew I want to get another cat, dude. But I didn't want to get one like right away. Really. So like with this cat, like with us like moving back and stuff, it's like, all right, well, let's just wait till we're, you know, moving back and like, you know, whatever. We'll put it off for a little bit. So we ended up getting the cat because like we ended up getting the cat here a couple weeks ago, dude, and like. It turns out, dude, because we knew the cat was gray, but dude, it turns out he looks exactly like Stanley.
Oh shit.
Like it's literally just like kind of like I see him off to the side, I'm like, oh, it looks exactly like Stanley. And I'm like,
nice.
To a point, I'm like, oh, this is like it's nice, dude. Like it is nice kinda to have him, you know, I don't know, like a clone, the reincarnation, whatever.
Yeah, for sure. You can just pretend like, yeah, what's that? There's some fucking movie, some clone movie where they bring back, oh, it's that like Total Recall or something, I think, where you can clone the animal.
Fucking Pet Cemetery.
Stanley, too. Yeah, Pet Cemetery. It's more like it. Yeah. Right. That's nice. So how old is it? A full, is it a cat or is it?
He was a kid, dude. So, I mean, he's a little bit older because she held on to him for a little bit longer.
Right.
So, I don't know. He's like, I think he's like fucking 2-3 months old.
Nice. That's always the best scenario, though, where it's just like, it just kind of comes up naturally. It's like, oh, it was meant to be, I suppose, this cat to be here.
Exactly, dude. Like it feels like it is meant to be. So I don't know, we're moving back, dude. He's coming back with us, so
nice.
I'm pretty stoked on it, dude.
Hell yeah, dude.
Right on, Jay Mcnay. That's where we come to an end here on the podcast, dude.
Nice. Cats.
We're gonna, you know, if there's a message for America out there, it's like less identity politics, more cats.
Come on, cats. That's it. That's what everyone needs right now. I know you're thinking there's already half the internet's already cats, but with our help and your help, we can get that up to 75-80% if we're lucky.
Yeah, dude. We got rookie numbers right now. We gotta pump it up, dude. Pump it up.
Nothing but cats. Just click on, get that algorithm going. Stop arguing and just click on any cat video you see out there.
Right on, dude. Well, hey, man, any final plugs?
Well, I guess apparently they say that we have a new wrestling little potty out there. So that is called Are You Ready? Search that on your pod app of choice.
Podcast app of choice. That's right, yeah, man. Supposedly we have a podcast that's, you know, all the kids are like, hey man, this is the best thing since sliced bread, man.
That's what they're saying. That's all the blogs and the internet forums are abuzz about it.
That's right, man. Well, all right, Jay Mcnay, I'm Kevin Porter. See you guys next time. Peace.
Bye-bye.
This podcast has been brought to you by Pizza Productions.